Mahalo to Real Hawaii Tours for sponsoring this video. The first part of the tour is a Honolulu city tour, so on the way to Pearl Harbor, you'll pass by important historic sites in downtown Honolulu, such as the palace and a few other historic sites, including the King Kamehameha statue. Next, we headed to Pearl Harbor. Pearl Harbor is a massive military base. The areas that we focused on were the two main museums and the USS Arizona program. It was really nice having the tour guide give us historical context for the different historic sites on the drive over to Pearl Harbor. This shows the different historic sites. So in addition to the USS Arizona, there's also the USS Bowfin submarine, the USS Missouri battleship, and the Aviation Museum. When you enter into the main visitor center, there are restrooms on the right-hand side as well as bag storage if you did bring a bag. Bags are not allowed within Pearl Harbor, but you can bring clear bags. Here at Pearl Harbor, there's two main museums. There is the beginning of the war as well as the end of the war. A few things to note. Clear bags are allowed. This is an example. You aren't allowed to have any bags that offer concealment. Backpacks, purses, handbags, fanny packs are all not allowed here at Pearl Harbor. There is a bag check-in at the entrance, which is $7 per bag. But to avoid all that, I would definitely recommend to bring clear bags instead. Clear bags as in those that are allowed at football stadiums.
You could easily spend an hour or so in this museum. For this video, we're just doing a quick walkthrough to show you what there is within this first museum. There's lots of placards that you can read, and there's an accompanying audio headset tour that you can purchase as well. On each specific placard, or most of the placards, there'll be a specific number where you can punch into the audio guide. For example, placard 123, you'll punch that into the audio headset, and then there's an accompanying audio bite that comes with it. It's really great if you're a history buff and you want to take the time to fully explore this museum. Would definitely recommend it.
I'm going to take you guys to the second museum to show you what that looks like.
Same thing for this second museum. For the video, we're just doing a quick walkthrough, but you could easily spend an hour in this museum watching the different presentations, also reading all the different placards, seeing the exhibits. There's video playing in the background, and there's also that accompanying audio headset that I had mentioned earlier in the video, which you're also able to purchase. After you go to the different museums, there is the USS Arizona Memorial Program. If you're curious about what this looks like, you'll meet at the specific place that I mentioned at the theater for your specific Arizona boarding time. From here, you'll take this ramp, which is handicap accessible, ADA compliant here. You'll go on board the naval launch, which is the boat that you see on the left-hand side over there. For those where accessibility may be a factor, again, all this area that I'm pointing out here has plenty of ramps. In the distance is the USS Arizona Memorial, and then over there is the USS Missouri battleship. So for this, you'll board the Navy launch, which is directly in front of us. From here, the boat ride is very short. It's only about 5 minutes or so. And then once you get to the memorial, that's when you'll actually be able to explore the memorial for about 15 minutes. So again, 5 to 7 minute ride from here to the USS Arizona Memorial. The launch boat or ferry that goes back and forth is run by the US Navy. This is the only way to get out to the USS Arizona Memorial. The ride itself is weather dependent. So if there are high winds or any other weather conditions where it is unsafe for the launch boat to go out, the Navy will cancel the trip to go out to the USS Arizona Memorial. This cancellation can happen the day before, the day of, or even 5 minutes before the tour time is supposed to start. Safety is their number one priority. This ride is about 5 to 7 minutes, and that in the video shows the second Navy launch boat. Again, going about every 15 minutes, the battleship over there and the Arizona Memorial on the right-hand side. Again, this portion of the trip is not narrated. There is a short safety briefing at the beginning, and then you'll disembark to get on the USS Arizona Memorial. There is a park ranger on the memorial itself if you have any questions, and there's also some placards and signs too. You're welcome to take photos or video on the way over there. This trip shows you what that ride looks like and how calm the water is typically. As a reminder, the USS Arizona Memorial is a memorial. It is the final resting ground for the sailors that died on that day. So out of respect, you will be reminded to turn off your cell phones, not take any phone calls, and keep your voices to a minimum while you're here on this site.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Arizona Memorial. At this time, we do have a couple rules. Is please do not stop anywhere on the outside structures to take any pictures or videos. Once you are inside the memorial, you are allowed to take as much pictures and videos. You're free to exit. It's just at this one time, please make your way all the way inside. Thank you and enjoy your visit.
In the background is the naval launch boat that will take you to the USS Arizona Memorial. It holds about 150 guests and it goes every 15 minutes. This walk on the outside here is the main walk that you can follow along with if you were to get the narrated Arizona tour. And then off in the distance, you can see the Arizona Memorial, and then you can also see the USS Missouri battleship as well. Those two are commonly known as the bookends of the war. So beginning of the war for the USS Arizona and then end of World War II, which is where the peace treaty was signed on the USS Missouri battleship. Throughout this walk, you'll see different information. You can also, with the narrated audio headset, follow along. The narrated audio headset runs about $8, and then the deluxe headset runs about $14. Just in front of us in the distance over there is the USS Bofin submarine. And then in terms of accessibility, there are quite a few benches that are around this area. Plenty of places to sit down. There's also a small snack shop that we showed you earlier in the video if you want to grab a quick bite to eat. The main cafe area that's over by the USS Bofin, you do have to purchase a ticket to the USS Bofin in order to access that cafe area. However, for this section, the snack shop is open to the public, and then there's also a small hot dog stand right by the USS Bofin Museum, which you don't have to purchase any ticket to have access to. Loop around here to this main area, and then these numbers that you see here are part of that audio tour that I mentioned earlier in the video, where guests can click on their audio headset that mentions a specific number, and they can hear the accompanying audio. The ride from the launch boat to the USS Arizona Memorial is about 5 to 7 minutes. It's continuously going with the launch boats, again, every 15 minutes, each launch boat holding about 150 passengers. Keep in mind too, with the USS Arizona, it is run by the Navy. If there's high winds, any issues with weather, sometimes there's issues with the dock for the USS Arizona launch boat that goes back and forth, that can cancel the Arizona ticket. And that again is all run by the Navy. Sometimes you'll get notified the day before, sometimes it can be as soon as 10 to 15 minutes before the actual timestamp that you have for the launch boat.
On the this one-page planner, you have everything that you need where you can jot down your details for your hotel, rental car, tours and activities, things that you want to do, and a general itinerary.